Students, the today topic is colligative properties of solution. In this properties, which depends only on the number of solute particles present in the solution. Colligative properties means collected together. A colligative property may be defined as one which depends on number of particles of solutes in the solution and not in any way on the size of the chemical nature of the particles. So it has the when the non-volatile solute is added in the solution, the property of the solution becomes changed, and that depends on the number of solute particles. The classification of a colligative properties: dilute solution containing non-volatile solute exhibit these properties. Number one is the lowering of vapor pressure, and number two is the elevation of boiling point, and number three is the depression in the freezing point, and number four is the osmotic pressure. So today we will discuss the three properties. Number one is the lowering of vapor pressure from the Raoult's law. You have discussed in the FSE classes, the vapor pressure of a pure solvent decreases by dissolving the non-volatile solute in it. For example, if you add the one solute in the solution, its vapor pressure becomes decreased, and automatically when you add the second solution, the solution concentration becomes increased and its vapor pressure becomes also will also more decrease. Let P is the vapor pressure of the solvent and PS subscript S of the solution the lowering in vapor pressure is P minus PS. Why this P becomes the pure vapor pressure of the pure solvent already increased. When you add the non-volatile solute in it, it becomes the solution and its vapor pressure becomes decreased. The lowering of vapor pressure relative to the vapor pressure of the pure solvent is termed the lowering of vapor pressure. Number relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to P minus PS divided by P. It divides on the vapor pressure of the pure solvents. So Raoult's law states that the relative lowering of the vapor pressure of a dilute solution is equal to the mole fraction of solute present in the dilute solution. So P minus PS over P is equal to N, small n divided by small n plus capital N. Here, n, small n is the number of moles of the or number of molecules of the solute, and capital N is the number of moles or number of molecules of the solvent. And next is the vapor pressure of the solution is determined by number of molecules of the solvent present at any time in the surface is proportional to the mole fraction. So PS is directly proportional to the capital N divided by small n plus capital N. N is the number of moles or molecules of the pure solvent, and small n is of the solution. So here proportionality constant is K. It K in N, so capital N divided by small n plus capital N. It becomes the equation A. So in case of pure solvent, N is equal to 0. So the mole fraction of the pure solvent is equal to N divided by small n plus N divided is equal to N divided by 0 plus N, because small n is becomes small n becomes equal to 0. So N divided by capital N is equal to 1. So the above equation A PS becomes equal to K, because the equation N divided by capital N is equal to 1. And PS is equal to P into N divided by small n plus N. This equation becomes second, and PS over P is equal to N plus N. So N divided by N, that is equal to plus N is equal to 1, so therefore 1 minus PS is equal to P, that is equal to 1 minus N, capital N divided by small n plus N. So P minus PS over P, that is equal to N divided by small n plus capital N. This is the Raoult law. Now you how we can find out the determination of a molecular mass from lowering of a vapor pressure. It is the second question. Now I want to understand you how the determination of the molecular mass becomes closer, and how we can calculate. So molecular mass of non-volatile solute can be determined by measuring the lowering of vapor pressure. So P minus PS produced by dissolving known weight to it. It is known as weight of the solvent. And the determination of molecular mass from lowering of vapor pressure. If W grams, small W grams of solute is dissolved in a capital W grams, we can denote it for the solvent. M is the for the molecular mass of the solute, and capital M is the molar mass of the solvent, pure solvent. Number of moles of solute N. So solute small n is equal to small w divided by small n, means known weight divided by molar mass. Number of molecular moles of the solvent, capital N is equal to capital W divided by capital M. So substituting these values in the Raoult's law equation, so P minus PS over P is equal to N divided by N plus N. So P minus PS over P is equal to N is equal to small w divided by small m, and divided by in the denominators small w divided by small m plus capital W divided by capital M. So since number of moles of or molecules of the solute, the small w over small m is very small, so it can be neglected here. In the denominator, then equation C becomes P minus PS over P is equal to small w capital M divided by small m capital W. So this is the equation in which we can determine the molecular mass of the pure solute. So knowing the experimental values of P minus PS over P and molecular mass of the solvent, the molecular weight of the solute small m can be calculated from this equation C and D. And next property is the relation elevation of boiling point. So relationship of elevation of boiling point with lowering of the in the vapor pressure. So liquid is heated, its vapor pressure rises, because you know that in the previous chapter, in the previous lecture, I have studied you that the vapor pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. When we heat the liquid, the vapor pressure of the liquid automatically rises. So when equal to the atmospheric pressure, so it automatically the liquid boils, because the definition of the boiling point is that when the external pressure becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. So when non-volatile solute number 1 is added to it, the vapor pressure and elevates the boiling points, it rises. So as solution heated to higher temperature, to make its vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure. So if TB is the boiling point of the solvent and capital T is the boiling point of the solution, so difference in boiling point delta T is called elevation in boiling point. So T minus TB is equal to delta T. Now how it becomes delta T? Ostwald Walker method of measuring the relative lowering of vapor pressure for dilute solutions. The curve here in this figure, the different curves A, B and C is represents here. For the curve A is the for the solvent, and for the curve B for the solution 1, and the curve C for the solution 2. It has two axes. One is the vapor pressure along y axis and the temperature along the x axis. Vapor pressure rises and it becomes equal to 1 atmosphere. So it boils at this point. Here the three curves A, B and C, and the one there is the intersection of the solvent and the solution 1, it's the point D, and the other the of the A and the solution 2, its point is the E. So number 1, the TB is the temperature, elevation in boiling point, and it is a T1 for the beaker and the C for the have the temperature, that is T2. So in this triangle, different triangles are becomes number one is the ACE. Here is the A, and number two is the C, and number three is the C. So these three points here, A, C, E is the first triangle, and A, B, D is the second triangle. So these triangles are equal. So AB over AC is equal to AD over AE, or T1 from the figure here. Again, you see here T1 minus TB is equal to TB divided by TB, T2 minus TB, that is equal to P minus P1. P is the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, and P1 is the vapor pressure of the solution 1, and P2 is the vapor pressure of the solution 2. So P minus P1 over P minus P2. Next is the here P minus P1 and P minus P2 are the lowering of vapor pressure are the solution 1 and 2. Hence the elevation of boiling point is directly proportional to the lowering of vapor pressure. So delta T is directly proportional to P minus PS. So how we can determine the molecular mass of this? So since P is a constant for the same solvent at a fixed temperature, so from the equation E, that is the delta T is directly proportional to the P minus PS. Delta T is directly proportional to P minus PS over P. That is the F equation here. And from the F equation, we can calculate, we can give the reference of the Rolle's law of the dilute solution, that is P minus PS over P is directly proportional to W small w over capital M over capital W small m. This is the equation G. And since M is the molar mass, capital M is the molar mass of the pure solvent, is constant for the two liquids. So from G, we can calculate it, P minus PS over P is directly proportional to W over small w over capital W into M. So from equation F and H, so delta T is equal to, delta T is directly proportional to W over M multiplied by 1 over W. So delta T is equal to KB into W over M multiplied by 1 over W. So KB is constant called boiling point constant, that is called bibliscopic constant of the mole or of molar elevation or molar elevation constant. So W over M is, if W over M is equal to 1 and capital W that is equal to 1 and KB is equal to delta T. So and if we can calculate the molar elevation in boiling point, and it's if 1 mole of the solute is dissolved in 1 kilogram of the solvent, it is called as molar elevation in boiling point. Next is the depression, freezing point depression. This has also the relation of the freezing point depression with lowering in vapor pressure. The vapor pressure of the pure liquid changes with the temperature as in curve A, B, and C from the figure. Here, the three figures here. First is the curve that from the solvent here, the solvent A is a and meet at the B point, and the next is the C for the pure solvent A and solvent, and for the second curve A for the solution 2 and third curve for the solution 3. So for depression in a freezing point, meet at the same point, that is the F point here. The F point is the for the solution 1 and solvent here meet, and for the next is the point, that is the C point where the solution 2 meets. When you add the non-volatile solute in it, the vapor pressure of the solution automatically becomes decreases, and if you add the second solution 2, its vapor pressure also decreases. So first is the TF, that is the freezing point depression, at which the three points merge at the same line, and the T1 for the solution 1 and the T2 for the solution 2. Here, the relationship between the depression of freezing point in lowering of vapor pressure of the pure liquid changes with temperature. So, as in curve A, B, and C from the first figure, for the pure solvent, there is sharp break at the B, where actually commences the point B is the freezing point of the pure solvent. The vapor pressure curve of the solution of the non-volatile solute in the same solvent, the vapor pressure curve of the solution 1 and solution 2 coincide at the point F. I have told you about this. So shows the freezing point of the solution, that is T1. And the second point, if for the solution 2 meets the difference in the freezing point of a solution and a solvent, represents the depression of freezing point, that is delta T or delta TF. So delta TF minus T1 is equal to delta T. So when more solute is added to the solution 1, it becomes concentrated solution, and the vapor pressure of the solution 2 meets the freezing point at the point C. So that is the results, the further decreases in the freezing point, that is T2. For the second, both for dilute solution, FD and CE are parallel, and BC is a straight line. So thus there are two triangles here, DF over EC. The here, the DF, one is the, here is the DF over EC is equal to the second one, DF over EC is equal to BD over BE. So TF minus T1 over TF minus T2 is equal to P minus P1 over P minus P2. Here the P minus P1 is the lowering in vapor pressure of the solution 1, and P minus P2 is the lowering in vapor pressure of the solution 2. So in the above equation, P1 and P2 are the vapor pressure, and depression of freezing point is directly proportional to the lowering of vapor pressure. Delta T is directly proportional to P minus PS. So since the P is constant for the same solvent, for the determination of molecular mass, so we can write delta T is directly proportional to P over PS, P minus PS over P. So, but from the Raoult's law for dilute solution, here P minus PS over P is equal to W capital M over W capital W small m. So this is the L equation, where M is molecular weight of the solvent, which is constant for all the solutions. So P minus PS over P, here the capital M is neglected, so the small W over capital W multiplied by M. So from the equation K and M, we can get delta T is directly proportional to W over M multiplied by 1 over W. So next, here the delta T is equal to KF. KF is the cryoscopic constant multiplied by small W over small M multiplied by 1 divided by capital W. So KF is called freezing point constant or cryoscopic constant or molar depression in constant. If W over M is equal to 1 and W is equal to 1 and KF is equal to T, so it is called as molar depression in constant. And if 1 mole of the solute is dissolved in the 1 kilogram of the solvent, it is called as molar depression in freezing point constant.